Good evening and welcome to Advent Cafe. Wherever you are, however you are able to connect, I am grateful that we can be together in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. As you can see tonight, you are joining me and my husband Dan in what we fondly call the fireside room of our house, although we don't have the fire going because it is May. Spring is definitely, if not on the horizon, then right around the corner.
I hope so.
Yeah. So no fire in the fireside room, but we're really glad that we can join you in prayer tonight from our home. And you'll also be able to join us in the sanctuary of St. George's tonight because all of the musical offerings from Brad Barnham were pre-recorded in the sanctuary. So you'll be back and forth between our home and your home and our church home. I invite you now to take a moment to access the song sheet for tonight. You'll find it in the service description on this YouTube page. You can click on that link. It will take you right to the song sheet. We encourage you to do that so that you can join with us in singing and praying along. And I invite you now to take a moment as we all prepare our hearts for worship.
Took a boat Sunday down by the sea. You just felt so nice. Sit down. down here on the ocean. We will stay, we will stay, we will stay. Been through a lot of changes, turned a lot of pages. When I took a boat on Sunday,
from the darkness of the grave, blood poured out, a crown of thorns, Christ the Lord is risen today.
Alleluia.
From the triumph that is won, over the power of fear and death, Christ the Lord is risen today.
Alleluia.
Walking from the empty tomb, opening wide the gates of life, Christ the Lord is risen today.
Alleluia.
Lord of life, you defeated death, to show that we can rise from all that binds us to the world, pride, envy, fear, anger, the debt of sin that holds us here, Christ the Lord is risen today.
Alleluia. Lord of life, you defeated death to demonstrate a love that is beyond our understanding, that reaches out even to me, saving grace to all who hear. Christ the Lord is risen today.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Lord of life, we pray for all who bring your word of life as a light to those in darkness, for those who bring your word of peace to those enslaved by fear, for those who bring your word of love to those in need of comfort. Lord of love and Lord of peace, Lord of resurrection life, be known through our lives and through your power. Christ the Lord is risen today.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Your heavy eyes will pay no expense. You will not cry for the days that went. And I will see you through this aching heart. I know the fear that shook your bones. It breaks your faith with the strength of stone. And I will see you through this endless night. You're never quite familiar with the strange at your door. He comes in bearing heartache and leaves you on your own. Although you must remember, the stranger comes and goes. You are my homestead, darling. I'll never let you go. Oh, A reading from a letter to the Corinthians. Now I would remind you, brothers and sisters, of the good news that I proclaimed to you, which you in turn received, in which you also stand, through which also you are being saved, if you hold firmly to the message that I proclaimed to you, unless you have come to believe in vain. For I handed on to you as of first importance what I in turn had received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. Then he appeared to more than 500 brothers and sisters at one time, most of whom are still alive, though some have died. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles, and last of all, as to one untimely born, he appeared also to me. For I am the least of the apostles, unfit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God I am what I am, and his grace toward me has not been in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we proclaim, and so you have come to believe. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
Thanks be to God.
Great is our God, sing with me, how great.
Let us pray. Risen One, as you broke bread with the disciples on the shore, meet us now in this gathering of prayer.
Nourish us to follow you, using our gifts to feed the hungry and tend the weary, and all for your love's sake. Amen.
Into your hands, O God, I commend my spirit.
For you have redeemed me, O God of truth and love.
Keep us, O God, as the apple of your eye.
Hide us under the shadow of your wings.
Preserve us, O Lord, while waking, and guard us while sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of thy people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Preserve us, O Lord, while waking, and guard us while sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace.
We give thanks to you, Lord, for you have done marvelous things. When we were walking in darkness,
you were there, you were there.
When we were kneeling in weakness,
you were there, you were there.
When we drew near feeling worthless,
you were there, you were there.
When we were needing forgiveness,
you were there, you were there.
When we were searching for your grace,
you were there, you were there. We give thanks to you, Lord, for you have done marvelous things. God of promise and God of hope, who through your great mercy have granted us new birth through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, we praise your wonderful name. God of glory and God of might, who through your great power have granted us new strength to endure all things through faith in Christ our risen King, we praise your wonderful name.
Lord, the resurrection of your Son has given us new life and renewed hope. Help us to live as new people in pursuit of the Christian ideal. Grant us wisdom to know what we must do, the will to want to do it, the courage to undertake it, the perseverance to continue to do it, and the strength to complete it.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Come on, oh my star is fading, and I swerve out of control. And if I'd only waited, I'd not be stuck here in this hole. Star is fading, and I swerve out of control. And I swear I waited and waited. I've got to get out of this hole. But time is on your side. On your side now, not pushing it down, and all around, though it's no cause for concern. Come on, oh my star is fading, and I see no chance of release, and I know I'm dead on the surface. You came along and you cut me loose.
I want to say a big thank you this evening to my husband Dan, not just for helping with this recording and prayer here at home, but also for doing all of the video editing this week and for being on site as Brad was doing his recordings to get all of those files and put them together and help us to lift up our prayer and song for this week. So thank you for going above and beyond.
Well, you have to let them in on the joke here. I'm laughing because this is the second time that we've recorded this because somebody forgot to unmute the button on the recorder.
Which we only discovered when we finally
got to the end. So this is round two for us, but feel free to put it on repeat and watch it again just to get the real feeling for it.
I mean, even having to record it twice, thank you for all of your extra work this week. And it's, you know, always a pleasure to get to pray night prayers together.
Sure thing, yeah, it is.
At 8 p.m. tonight, you'll be able to tune in to Dessert and Dish. I'm going to be interviewing Archdeacon Marian Vincette, who has an incredible legacy of service and leadership in the life of our church and is currently serving as honorary assistant at St. George's. It was actually by popular request to have her on for Dessert and Dish. We had a wonderful conversation. I know that you're going to enjoy it. So take a break after Advent Cafe, grab something sweet to eat, and join us for a wonderful conversation at 8 p.m. tonight. This coming Thursday, so that is May the 13th, I'm going to be speaking in the Spirituality and Food Speaker Series that is held through Five Oaks Retreat Center. It's just $5 to participate in the one evening, come and hear me speak. I would love to see some familiar faces. It's, I think, $25 for the whole series, which is already underway, but honestly, it's a great deal, and all of the speakers are fantastic. So if you want more information about that, I can share that sign-up link with you. That's this coming Thursday, May the 13th. And I don't know whether I said thank you to Brad. Thank you to Brad for his musical leadership this week, and thank you to all of you for taking the time to be with us in prayer.
Christ is risen.
The world below lies desolate.
Christ is risen.
The spirits of evil are fallen.
Christ is risen.
The angels of God are rejoicing.
Christ is risen.
The tombs of the dead are empty.
Christ is risen indeed from the dead. The first of the sleepers. Glory and power are his forever and ever.
Amen.